What are the challenges that you faced with Ovation? Let's talk about Ovation now. When you started and when you look back 24 years down the line, I mean, what are the major challenges
There
that
is no challenge I will talk about that you are not aware of, because it's the same game. Number one, publishing is a casino. I call it the ultimate casino. It's a calo-calo. And it's the only business that even the business schools cannot teach, because it's a practical thing. I don't even think a professor of journalism can write about what I've gone through with Ovation. It's not possible. It's part of the reason I'm a fellow at Oxford University, trying to put these things together, you know. So I'm going to write a paper, and I'm going to write about my experience publishing Ovation. And you know, these universities, they are always looking for knowledge about practical ways of doing things. So it's very, very tough. We started, our business plan revealed that we needed 150,000 pounds, but we could barely raise 20,000 at the beginning. In fact, one of my business partners then pulled out on the eve of starting Ovation. He said my ideas were too fantastic, my ideas were too crazy, were too unrealistic. Everybody says I am unrealistic. I'm a risk taker. That's the thing about me. But I take calculated risks. A lot of people don't want to take any risk. They want everything to be, you know, ready made. But for me, I know that life is not ready made. So we had 20,000 pounds, and I told the guy we should go and spend 14,000 pounds on getting a beautiful office in London, in Docklands. And the guy felt, how can you spend 14 out of 20? You are going to be left with only six. So how will you move forward? But my own idea was that a man who is down should fear no fall. You are already down. We couldn't raise any finance. I went to my manager at the National Westminster Bank in London to see if we could get a loan. She said no, because I was new to doing business in England. So I had no history of doing any business. So I didn't have a credit history, so no credit rating. So nobody will give you a loan. But what was my idea? My idea is, what is that one important thing that we can buy with the money we have that will catapult us and galvanize us into the next level? Image. The first thing I learned from all the big people I worked for, from Chief Omoburuwu to Obakun Adesuju Ade, to Chief MKO Abiola, to Dr. Michael Adenuga, to Mr. Kim Bello Osage, I've been very fortunate at different times to work in one capacity or the other, to Ndụka Ọbaigbena, you know, as the founder of Leaders and Company at that time in 99. So cumulatively, the experience was so humongous that I knew that nobody does business with a poor man. You cannot go to a rich man and say, I have this business idea. Excuse me, sir. This business, you are going to get us a warehouse. You are going to buy us pickup vans. You are going to buy this. And the man will be looking at you like, are you crazy? Am I your father? But if people get the impression that, like the Yorubas, the sweeter and Yoruba, that you have the capacity for the business you want to do, you will see how people will rush at you. So that was my idea. But my friend, he was not ready to take such a risk, so he pulled out. So in fact, we had to register a new company, Ovation International Limited, urgently for us to be able to get the office. Because to do the office, you will need to write on your letterhead, you will need referees, you need all kinds of things. So then we got the office in an office called Beaufort Court at South Quay Station in Docklands. You will not believe this. The very day we moved into that office, a bomb exploded next door. I started running. Abacha, Abacha, Abacha. I thought Abacha had traced me to London and they were going to kill me in that building. And we didn't know that the police had evacuated the whole area and everything. That was our first major challenge. We were just drinking and toasting to starting a new business. Boom. we took off, only to realize that it was IRA, the Irish Republican Army, used to strike from time to time, throwing bombs around London at the time. So, and Docklands was the new place in vogue.